I'm Kendall Roberg, and today we're going to talk about exponents that are fractions. Up here we have 25 to the 1/2 power. What does that mean? Well, it turns out 25 raised to the 1/2 power is the same as taking the square root of 25. So what does the square root of 25 mean? I've always thought of square roots as, what number would I have to square to get the radicand? So what number times itself, equals 25? Well, 5 times 5 equals 25. We call each of these 5s a square root of 25. So the square root of 25 is 5. And also, 25 to the 1/2 power is 5. Let's try another one. How about negative 27 to the 1/3 power? Now, negative 27 to the 1/3 power is actually the same as finding the cube root of negative 27. So now, because we're dealing with a cube root instead of a square root, we have to think of what cubed would give us negative 27. So what times itself and times itself again equals negative 27. Well, with a little investigation and guess and check, you could probably come up with negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 equals negative 27. Because negative 3 times negative 3 is 9, times another negative 3 is negative 27. Let's try another one. How about 32 to the 1/5 power? Now what we have to take is actually the 5th root of 32. And to answer this, we have to ask, what raised to the 5th power would equal 32? So what times itself one more time equals 32. And it turns out the number 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, well, let's see, 2 times 2 is 4, 8, 16, 32. So yes, 32 to the 1/5 power is 2, and the 5th root of 32 is 2. Oh, and I guess we never filled this one out. Negative 27 to the 1/3 power was negative 3. The cube root of negative 27 is negative 3. So there we go. Now let's try one a little more complicated. What if we're dealing with 4 to the 5/2. Now this is a little more challenging because the numerator of our fraction in our exponent is not 1 like it was in each of these situations. If it was 1, it would be a lot easier to deal with. So here's the trick. We can use the properties of exponents to change the numerator in our exponent to 1. Let's rewrite 4 to the 5/2 as 4 to the 1/2 raised to the 5th power. Now, if we simplify this, we'd end up back here. But when we have it written at this form, we can see that 4 to the 1/2 is the same as taking the square root of 4. So this is the same as the square root of 4 raised to the 5th. The square root of 4 is 2, so 2 raised to the 5th. And we already found out that 2 raised to the 5th is 32. So 4 to the 5/2 is 32.